Hello students of computational thinking. In this tutorial video, we will try to do some of the same procedures that the professors have done in lecture 2. Except what they have done is on the mark sheet data set. And here we will work with the shopping bills data. As you can see here, these are the shopping bills that we are using. And they're all randomized. So this is bill number 3, this is bill number 11, 18, and so on. So this is not in a particular order. Now let us start looking at our first problem. We see that food is a very common category of purchase in our bills. So let us try to count the number of purchases where there is no food at all, or where there is only food and no other category. So for this, we will maintain two variables. One will be all food count, and the other one will be no food count. So every time a bill comes up which has only food, we shall increment the all food count variable. And wherever there is a bill without any food, we will increment the no food count variable. And we initialize these variables to the number 0. So let's begin with this. This is our first shopping bill. And as you can see, there is food, but there's also toiletries. So there is nothing to increment here. This is neither all food nor no food. So the next bill here, there is food, 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 food. And then there is one household item. So again, neither all food nor no food. So we are not incrementing anything. And here we see everything is food. There is no non-food item in this purchase. So this one will lead to an increment in the all food count variable. So that makes it plus one. And here again we see food, 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 but toiletries. So we do not make any increment. And here we see food and toiletries, no increment again in either variable. And here we see food and apparel, so no increment again in either variable. And here we see utilities and food, no increment. Apparel, apparel, household, apparel, but food. So again, no increment. And now we have come to a bill where there is no food item at all. So we will increment the no food count by 1. So both are on 1 now. Going further, toiletries and food, so no increment. Food, apparel, so no increment. Only food, right. So all food count is now incremented by 1. We are at 2. Again, all food, so we are now at 3 on the all food count. No food count is still at 1. And here we have apparel and food, so no increment. All food again, so increment all food by 1, so we now are at 4. No food, so that will be 2. Food and stationery, so no increment. Food, food, food and cosmetics, so no increment. And all household items, so no food increments by 1, so we're at 3. Utilities, electronics, stationery and food, so no increment. Only stationery, so we are now at 4 on the no food count. Household and food, so no increment. Only food again, so increment all food count by 1. and there's no food on this, so no food count also is incremented by 1. All food again, only food, so all food count is incremented by 1. All food count is again incremented by 1. One more increment for all food count, and now one increment for no food count. One more increment for all food count, and one more for all food count. I think now we have reached 10, and we have also reached the end of the data set. This is the last card. So if I close this, you can see that we are at the last card. So these are the counts we have arrived at after iterating through the shopping bill data and maintaining two separate variables for counting bills which have no food at all and bills which have only food as all the purchased items. Now let's do another problem, which is similar to what the professors have done in the lecture video. So for that, let's go to the words data set. And again, here I have randomized it considerably. And this is what the data cards look like. What we shall do in this problem is we will try to calculate the average word length in this data. So we have the letter count here. So we're going to use this to calculate the average of the word length. And for this, as the professors have done with the maths average in the lecture for the marksheet data, we will maintain two variables again. One would be the count of the cards, how many cards are there, and the other is the sum of the letter count. So that way, at the end of it, we'll have the sum of all the letters, the total number of letters, and also the total number of words. So if we divide the sum by the count, we should be able to get the average word length in this data. So beginning with the first card we have in the order, the sum we will initialize it to 0, and the letter count also we will initialize it to 0, and now we are adding 11 to this letter count. The next card we have 10, which gives us the sum to be 21 and the count is 2. And this one again is 11, which gives us the count to be 3 and the sum to be 32. And once again we have 10, so this is 42, count is 4. Now we have letter count of 8, which gives us the sum to be 50 and the count to be 5. And again we have a 10, which gives us the sum to be 60 and the count to be 6. And now we have a 9, the sum is 69 and the count is 7. And we have a 10 again, so the sum is 79 and the count is 8. And now we have a 9 again, so the sum is 88 and the count is 9. Another 9, so the sum is 97 and the count is 10, plus one more 9, so the sum is 106 and the count is 11. And now a 6, so the sum is 112 and the count is 12. And now another 9, so the sum is 121 and the count is 13. Now we have an 8, the sum is then 129 and the count is 14. And now we have a 6, the sum becomes 135 and the count is 15. And here we have yet another 6, the sum is 141 and the count is 16. Now we have an 8. The sum is 149. Count is 17 plus 5 on the sum and plus 1 on the count. Then again, plus 8 on the sum, giving us 162, plus 1 on the count, giving us 19. Then we have a 6 additionally, making it 168, and we have 20 cards. One more 6, so 174, 21 cards, plus a 7, sum is 181 for 22 cards. We have one more 7, which is 188 sum for 23 cards. Plus 6 again, sum is 194, cards is 24. Plus 4, sum gives 198 and count is 25. Plus 3, the sum is 201, the count is 26. Plus 4, sum is 205, cards is 27. Plus 3, sum is 208, number of cards is 28. Then we have a plus 7, giving us sum is 215 and number of cards is 29. Plus 7 again, sum is 222, number of cards is 30. Plus 4, 226 and 31. Plus 3, 229 and 32. Plus 6, 235 and 33. Plus 4, 239 and 34. Plus 2, 241 and 35. Plus 4, 245 and 36. Plus 2, 247 and 37. Plus 5, 252 and 38. Plus 2, 254 and 39. Plus 2 again, 256 and 40. Plus 2 again, 258 and 41. Plus 4, 262 and 42. Plus 4, 266 and 43. Plus 4 again, 270 and 44. Plus 4 again, 274 and 45. Plus 3 is 277 and 46. Plus 2 is 279 and 47. Plus 2 again, 281 and 48. Plus 3 is 284 and 49. Plus 3 again is 287 and 50. Plus 3 again is 290 and 51. Plus 3 again, 293 and 52. Plus 3 again, 296 and 53. Plus 3 again, 299 and 54. Plus 306 and 56. Plus 3 is 309 and 57. Plus 3 again, which is 312 and 58. Plus 3, 315 and 59. Plus 3, 318 and 60. Plus 3, 321 and 61. Plus 2, 323 and 62. Plus 2, 325 and 63. Plus 2 is 327 and 64. Plus 2 again gives us 329 and 65. So now we perform division of the sum quantity by the count quantity, which is 329 by 65, which gives us an average word length of pretty much 5, roughly 5. It is 5.06, but since these are words, we can say that this paragraph has an average word length of about 5 letters a word. Thank you.